What's good, CNC gang? Y'all already know it's your boy Chris.
Hey, girl Crystal.
If you're new to the channel, make sure you click that subscribe button, click that bell, turn on your post notifications, and come and join the family. Guys, the moment y'all been waiting for. OMG, it's been a very long time, guys. We've been actually drifting away from this type of video, and we been feeling like
it's time
and it's the right time. So guys, as y'all can tell by the title, you know, here goes nothing.
You guys are gonna be able to
grab your popcorn. I'm telling you right now, because this video is gonna be at least 30 minutes long. So
I hope that I'm hoping to get this video done quickly. Not that quick, because I do want to put you guys on. Right. Remember, the title is How We Met. It don't go for
story time.
Story time.
So
how did we meet? We met 14 years ago.
Ooh, shout out to us, baby. 14 years, y'all already know you date. Marriages don't even last that long. I'm sorry,
it's
but
14 years, really?
Yeah, hard. You know what I'm saying? 14 years, your boy gotta. I respect myself, baby.
Guys, if you guys haven't hit that subscribe channel,
hit this subscribe channel right now.
The subscribe channel.
Hit the subscribe button right now, guys. Like, don't mind us because we don't know what we're talking
and
about.
And we definitely ain't drinking, so.
Yeah, we ain't drinking right now. We just drinking some energy drinks, so.
Yeah, that's that new Rock drink, so.
Yeah, shout out to Rock for that.
It's really good. But 14 years ago, in Harlem.
On, I ain't even gonna give you a street, guys.
Yeah, we can't go there.
I was about to go there, but nah, I ain't gonna do that. But y'all already know, if y'all know Harlem, y'all know Harlem, that's where we from, so.
Spanish town, yes, we are from New York, we are from Harlem. I am from the Lower East Side. I actually am from all over the place because I went from like Lower East Side to the Bronx to Harlem. I mean, what, your brother lived in Brooklyn.
Yeah, my brother lived in Harlem with us. He moved to Brooklyn.
So, I mean, we kind of like from almost all over the place, but I grew up on the Lower East Side, and...
God, I'm about to come out of character right now, excuse me. East Side!
No! So, back to how we met. How did we meet?
Listen, let me tell the story. God, I'm telling you, it's going to get crazy.
All right,
so... you know, me growing up in Harlem, I was a little badass, and you know, that's gonna get to the point because y'all gonna probably be like, what is he talking about? But listen to this guy, New York, I was a badass, you know. And one day, you know, I had my long hair, I had my braids and shit like that. And yeah, I was coming from court, guys. Literally, I was coming from court, you know, I just came up the stairs. In a train station, and I spotted this beautiful thing. Like, it was the sun shining on her. It was an angel that came down. And I'm like, yo, ma. I was with my moms that day. And I'm like, yo, ma, you got to wait right here, you know? I got to run across the street. But I want to show y'all how I did it, you know? Because this is just not a sit down. This is a physical thing. Like, it's only right if I get into physical things, you know? So I was like this, guys. Excuse me. Let me just back this up. So I seen her across the street, right? And I'm like, yo, ma, hold on, right? So I'm like, I'm running across the street, and I'm like, yeah. I'm like, yo, what's up? Hold on, let me bring you guys closer. So
that is not what he
said. No, wait. So she went into the store, right? So I ran across the street, and she went into the store.
We were young, this was 14 years ago.
And back then, we used to smoke cigarettes. So I'm in the store, and I'm behind her. And you know my young ass ain't got, you know, I thought I had game at the time, and I'm standing behind her, and I'm like, she walks out the store, and I'm like, damn. And then she looks, and I look, and I call her over like that. And boom, guys, we get to talking, but you know what's crazy?
No, it didn't happen that way. I want to tell my story up to that part. Okay, so yes, right, I'm on my way to my mom's house, right? So I'm about to jump on a train, and I'm like, damn, all right, I gotta go to the store. Probably, I don't know, like he said, we used to smoke, and I probably end up getting me a pack of cigarettes because I can't remember exactly what it is that I was buying from the store that day. Getting me a pack of cigarettes, and then I was about to go down to the train station, and as I'm paying for whatever it is that I'm buying, all I heard was, damn. And I was like, what?
She walked out the store.
I didn't even turn around, guys. I did not even turn around. I didn't turn around. I turned the other way because I felt like there was like a sound coming from this way. So I went this way. and I walked out the store. But when I walked out the store, you know, curiosity sometimes ends up messing
she
you up.
She turned around and put it like this. She peeped your boy. I already know. She was like, damn, he looked mad good.
So he was at the window like this, right? He was at the window.
So what? Because I couldn't see, you know, oh, you know when you're looking through the bag of chips, you know, the how you call it? Like, it was the stand.
Holder.
Yeah, the chip holder was against the wall, like, near the window. So I'm like, I'm kind of like looking through the chips, and I see her eyes, like, you know, so we connect. And I'm like, yeah, yo, Walla, let me get a bogey, you know, like, and I run out the store, and I'm like, you know, I start talking. Do you believe she was the first girl that I've never lied to? As soon as I started talking to her, my age, everything. Guys, I was young, you know, I used to lie to the girls back then, you know, that's how, you know? But that's a different story.
So what happened?
But she was the only one, hold on, let me say this. She was the only one I have never lied to since the day I met her.
So then I go down the stairs. I'm like, I'm not talking to this kid. I'm not gonna go talk to him and be like, oh, damn, right?
5 minutes later,
tell
them.
Something told me when I walked downstairs, I was like, damn, you know what? I'm gonna just go upstairs because the train wasn't there yet. I'm gonna go upstairs and smoke a cigarette.
That's a lie, yo.
No.
That's a lie. She came back up from the stairs. She went down after we was talking. I knew she was
feeling.
We didn't
talk.
Yes, we did.
You asked me for a light.
No, and we started talking. I started talking to you in front of the train station.
No, you didn't. You got it wrong.
She went downstairs and came back up and asked me for a light. That's how I knew she was feeling.
Because, okay, when I went to go down the stairs, you was like, yo, can I talk to you? And I was
exactly.
Like,
then we started talking.
No, and I left. I went downstairs.
Oh, she lied. She did not say
lying.
No.
I'm not lying.
I swear to my mother, you didn't say no.
Well, then I probably didn't say anything.
Nah, she said, yeah, we was talking first.
I went down the stairs, and when I went downstairs, I came back up and I asked you for a lay. I was trying to smoke a cigarette.
She's saying.
To be honest, it was to, like, actually hold a conversation with you, but at first, I wasn't trying to have it.
Everything she said is true, but the only thing that's not true is after we talked, she went downstairs and then she came back up and then asked me for a lighter. That's how I knew she was feeling me. And you know, the next day I pulled up to her window and you know, we got to talk and it was like, it was crazy because her.
Did we talk that night?
I don't think we talked that night.
We exchanged numbers and I went down to my mom's house and I was like, my, I just met this kid. Like, I literally just bumped into him. He looks hype young, but he's so cute. And I'm like, and I didn't even think of it. Like, and it was from there. That's how we met, guys.
She went to her mom's house and she started talking to her mom about me. Everybody started saying I was young and everybody said I look like a girl. I look like a girl. I look like a girl? That's fucked up.
But anyway, guys,
she was feeling your boy and you know, I had to snatch her up.
I met him in he had some gray sweats, a white tee.
I was in the hood, I was dressed in hood and you know how the hood is, but I was crazy. God, I was all bummed out.
What
I was just sweats out, hair with braids, looking crazy.
His hair was messed up.
Coming from court, like, you know, I was bad, guys. Like, I was like, you know, I had to run across the street and just that's when my life changed, man. Like, God changed everything for me that day I ran across the street. It was like running from one side of life that was really bad to the other side of life that's really good. So
I was in school. I was in college at the time. I was like trying to put my head straight on my shoulders and everything. And here comes Chris.
14 years later, guys, like, yo. And it's crazy how we still remember that story, like,
do you
off
remember
the
what I was
back
wearing?
Of the head.
I was blonde at the time. I was like cherry blonde.
I know you had like some Pepe jeans.
Oh my God.
Pepe jeans with some Jordans. I think she had Jordans on. She had the Jordans on. You know how girls in the hood, they be thinking they fly. They have the Pepe jackets, the Pepe jeans.
That is
not. Or Jordans. Yo, we had some crazy back in the days, bro. That shit was crazy. Like,
I I'm telling you,
I do not regret every single moment living in the hood. Like, that's how my mom raised us in the hood. I was born and raised in Harlem, 25 years.
I miss home.
I've seen some shit. I've been through some shit, like,
and we met each other in a freaking...
It's crazy, guys.
In the middle of...
Projects.
Well, it wasn't the project, but
yeah. It wasn't like the projects. It was somewhat like a downtown area because it left from my area to her area. So we kind of met in the middle. But it's crazy, guys. Like, whoever's from Harlem and New York know that Harlem back then was crazy. You know, shout out to Jefferson Projects. Shout out to, just the hood, man. Just the hood, you know. I love all the people in the hood, and I will never forget home. I say I will never forget home. I will never forget where I came from. And yeah, guys, it was just an amazing story.
Yeah, so that's how we met, guys. I know you guys probably have been waiting for that for a really long time. I have been putting it off for a really long time.
Yeah, she's the one I actually been holding it off, so that's why we didn't make this video. Don't get on me, get on her. Because I wanted to do it like months ago.
9 years. I just felt like it wasn't time yet.
And now it's time, guys. I hope you actually had your popcorn for this one when you seen the title. And I hope you guys watch the video through, because when you do watch the video through, it helps us out and it spreads to other people. Please give this video a big thumbs up, because when you give it a big thumbs up, it also spreads to a lot of people. And we want to show love and positivity, and we want all our CNC family to come and join us. So guys, I hope you did enjoy this video, because it was crazy. I feel like it was crazy, but she's stopping me because I could say a lot of things.
I think this video is long enough.
13 minutes, guys, 13 minutes.
Listen, I don't know, but the story, it's the story time. This is the beginning of the story. The rest of the story is still to come.
If you wanted part two, guys, comment below. And the only way we're gonna do a part two, if we get at least 5,000 views on this video.
And 1,000 likes, and we might do a Q&A.
Oh, Q&A next.
Yeah, we got a lot of questions in TikTok. So
guys, so comment below, DM us, everything, all your questions, guys, so we can make a Q&A. But without further ado, guys, again, I hope you did enjoy this video. I'm Wyatt. Shout out to Rock for the Zoa, because it is really amazing. This is not sponsored. I'm not sponsoring it, guys, but this is actually amazing. So I'm Wyatt right now, and I think I have to drink this when I make videos, because this is good. This is really good. But y'all already know, guys, we love you. Thank you for always tuning in, like always. Y'all already know, it's your boy, Chris.
And your girl, Crystal.
And we out, guys. Peace. Bye.